Governor Bryant signed the Literacy-Based Promotion Act into law in 2013. The purpose of the Literacy-Based Promotion Act is to eliminate social promotion and to ensure that our third grade students are prepared for fourth grade reading instruction. The Mississippi Department of Education responded to the specifications of this law by providing professional development to teachers, but also providing literacy coaches to work in our lowest performing schools in the state. The data indicated that Key Elementary was one of our lowest performing schools as it relates to third grade student performance. So a literacy coach was placed in Key. Since 2013, we have seen sustainable growth at Key Elementary School, where we see our evidence of our best practices that are put in place. We see our teachers who are now becoming teacher leaders, and they're able to lead our professional learning communities. And we also see an improvement in our data and the different types of discussions that our administrator is having with teachers, but also the discussions that our teachers are having with their students as it relates to meeting their goals. As literacy support schools begin to show growth in our areas, we use our gradual release model. So we now have schools that are receiving full support, limited support, and then those schools that have now made it off our literacy support school list because of the growth and the gains that we've seen, not just in data, but in also culture and climate at the school. Key Elementary in Jackson is one of 9 schools in the state that have demonstrated that sustainable growth, and therefore this year was removed from our literacy support school list.
Those coaches, you know, actually came in to assist providing several professional development with teachers and then coming back to see if those best practices were in place when they came back. So it was like a teach you and then come back to see if you're monitoring to see if these actual professional developments are actually being implemented. Everything is data driven. Everything that we do is, like I said, data driven. We have data all across the building. From the students even know the data. They track their own data too as well bi-weekly. Data is always shared with across the board with everybody, no matter who comes into the building. Not just with the literacy coach, it could be a parent, it could be a community leader, whoever it may be. We share data all the time. There's no secrets in our data. It is what it is with our data.
What we do as coaches to really build the relationship with the teachers and the rapport with the teachers, what we really do is we come in and observe. And our first observations, we make sure that we leave positive notes about the positive things that we're seeing going on. Once we do that, we also meet with the teachers in the beginning of the year PLC. There we go over our teacher coach partnership agreement, and we stress our role is not evaluative, and that's really important because teachers then feel the stress off and they can actually tell us the needs that they have. They can tell us the things they don't know how to do, and then we can help them develop those skills that they can use. And oftentimes after you do a model lesson, let's say you're going to another classroom, the kids they're like, please don't go. The kids react that way to us because they enjoy the interaction that we have, the engagement that we provide with the lessons that we're teaching with them. The kids really enjoy being part of the process as well.
She came in, she created a rapport with them as well. She made sure that she was welcoming and inviting to them, and they were also happy to see a new face in the classroom. I do believe having a literacy coach is a form of professional development. She came in, she made sure we had resources that we need. She was able to come in and co-teach. She was able to give positive feedback and constructive criticism. She also came in and provided us with the resources that we needed to help the students, those who were struggling as well as those who were more advanced.
We provide literacy support for kindergarten through third grade teachers. However, if there's pre-K or fourth and fifth in the building, if we're doing something that they would benefit from, whether it be a professional development on a particular strategy like closed reading, something they would benefit from, we definitely invite them to participate in it. Because if it's something that would be beneficial to them, we definitely want to provide it for them.
There was progress made, not in just our ELA block. We also noticed changes with math, social studies, and science just across the board, because one thing I personally believe is you first learn to read and then you read to learn. You cannot do a math problem or understand a math problem or comprehend it if you cannot read it. Same thing with science and social studies. We did integrate science and social studies into reading. That's where that read informational piece comes from. So we did see improvements there. And whether the literacy coach was here or not, we were able to, you know, remain in constant contact at all times, whether it was through phone or email. Anytime we needed help with anything or had a question, you know, they were open to helping.
As far as having the literacy coach in the classroom, I was comfortable with it. I feel that anybody that's willing to come in and help and give me some expertise on ways that I can reach my scholars is always great. The literacy coach and myself, we would sit down and look at the data together and kind of see where the students grew and what skills we may need to go back over, and then we would come up with a game plan for reaching those skills with the students the next go round.
The culture of the school is everybody helps everybody. Our motto is we're AEIOU. Academic excellence is our ultimate goal, and everybody is somebody at our school, so that means that nobody is left behind on with teaching and learning.